We're nearly there. The trapdoor is within our grasp. Just a little bit further to go, and the beacon shall be ours. What do you mean, reconnect the controller? The only reason this propped up is because I pressed the B button, which means that you recognize the controller is working. What are you doing?
Hey, you. All right, you know, screw this thing.
Well, look, even if it was a treasure map, it's not gonna do you much good down here.
Hey! What's going on here with you all? How's it going?
Oh, hi, Reese! Gordas.
Gordas.
Say Reese.
Gordas. What?
Nothing.
Why'd you do this to me, Gordas? I can't believe you've done this.
Said Reese.
How much of a beating did you lay on these two, huh? Clearly they're brain damaged.
I mean, just like the regular amount.
Come on. Clearly not the way this one's babbling on.
So what is it that I can help you with, Mr. Vasquez? Because if it's related to the incident upstairs, this is all under control. Just another case of vandalism on the Handsome Jack tour.
That's confidential information that I can't divulge. Just hand over the prisoners and stay out of the way.
I don't understand.
You know, you must not be a big fan of having a job questioning one of your superiors like this.
No, it's not that. It's just strange is all.
What's strange is that you're still standing here. How about you go take an early lunch and I'll try and forget this insubordination. Or would you rather I just fire you on the spot?
Leaving now, sir.
I'm pretty sure that is Troy Baker trying to do the Vasquez voice. And he does a damn good job of it. I don't think they cheated by having Vasquez do the voice even when the synthesizer is broken.
So, what is this plan, exactly?
I found out about a trapdoor that leads to Jack's office. We just gotta figure out a way up.
Oh, where, why would...
So I'm guessing the plan doesn't involve you getting mulched by a death machine?
No, that's a problem.
How can we help?
By figuring out a way to shut that thing off so I can get up there. Then I pull you up on the comm so you can identify the piece.
Sounds like a plan.
Alright, is there a big green off button like this maybe? I mean, usually off buttons aren't green, but you know, I'm assuming one of the red buttons will do the trick. Or the left. No, that. Oh, is that easy? Yeah, you just gotta hold the lever in place. Okay. Alright, Fiona, come over here. Hold up that lever.
Alright, I get it now. So, Fiona, I need you to hold this while Gordas.
I think Jack did mention something like that previously.
Don't worry about hurting me. Just climb on up.
Well, I guess it's tough to hurt someone made of metal.
Oh no, this is excruciatingly painful. But hey, I'm a team player. Reese wouldn't let us down.
Oh, you haven't been around him as long as I have.
How could you possibly doubt? Possibly doubt? Okay, are you moving?
Not even a little.
That's just not true. Like that's just factually incorrect. She clearly is moving. I can see her moving.
There.
With my eyes.
No problem.
Hurry up, Reese.
Okay. Oh my god, that's more than a little boost, Gordas. Activated moon launch mode accidentally. Too much.
I could have expected. Thanks.
No problem.
Try not to die.
Thanks, Fiona.
Reese, you all right?
No.
Nope. Good thing I got that puking out of my system.
Maybe we should step away.
From the lever?
Reese, you can do it. Climbing with your cyber arm should be easy.
Easy, right? Stupid, nice robot.
You heard her.
Climb.
That's what we're doing. Just... Is that a vet?
You've got impeccable timing.
Hey, I don't know when you gave them the slip, but Finch and Kroger are out there looking for you, and things are gonna get messy if you start messing with us. Don't forget what's on the line here. You get us what we want, what we agreed to.
Look, we had to change plans. There were complications.
Well, let me uncomplicate it. Get the beacon, bring it to me.
Yeah, working on it.
Good.
for now. We'll see what happens when this all goes terribly wrong and we have to leave you behind. And what a tragic day that will be. We have to sacrifice you for the greater good. The greater good being our greater good. Well, someone's got a bit of an ego.
Hey, check you out. You made it.
Oh, good. It's been sealed shut.
In the end, we make a pretty good team, huh? I mean, we had our differences, but we got here. My office. Well, our office now.
This place is just overflowing with assholes. I don't know how I stood it for so long.
'Cause you had to. But hey, you're in the big leagues now.
Wow. I used to dream about being here. Anyway, where's the Gordis Beacon?
It's gotta be over there somewhere. It's where all the corporate warfare fallout is. Ton of Atlas crap. Soak it in, kid. Enjoy yourself. Yeah, there's really no rush here. Just take it easy. Soak in the sights.
Or I could get to work trying to track down Gordis's beacon. Which I imagine is somewhere over here.
Welcome to my trophy case, huh? Got a couple of killer relics, a few artifacts. Oh, there's a stock certificate signifying that I own Atlas. That's pretty freaking cool. Nothing feels better than crushing a company's value to the point where you can buy all their shares with pocket change. It's delish.
Gordis, you there?
Hey!
Hi. Okay, so I'm gonna show you the pieces now. You let me know which one it is, all right?
Okie dokie!
Unidentified corporate object X is where gonna be first thing I think of, but it probably won't be that because it makes too much sense. Yeah, that's what I thought. Let's see, what do we got? We got a sexy hat. Ooh.
Nope, a cute cowboy hat.
I was really hoping it was the cowboy hat.
Yeah, I don't, have a cowboy hat. That was my girlfriend's hat. Well, her first one before she became a sexy badass sheriff type chick. He suited her.
More Borderlands game references, I'm assuming. It's not the certificate. Could be this. Or maybe we put all three of them together. Or it could be this. Oh wait, no, that's just no. No, that's just a
a goatee. Yeah. It belonged to the jackass Earl Tassiter, my former boss. I like to keep that around as a reminder of what happens when you act like a dick to me.
Well, see, this is what I was trying to look at, not the goatee. This is what I wanted to look at.
Yeah, that's it. That's the one. The U-shaped thing with the little spear.
Great. I'll be down there in a minute.
Okay. See you soon.
How can you possibly screw this up now?
Okay. Here we go. The big seat is all yours. You trigger the trap door from there.
Trust that, I do not. My trust of this is non-existent, Mr. Jack. Can I sit in Jack's chair? Don't like that.
Feels good.
That'd be the contact-activated dopamine injectors. You look like somebody who could kill a bunch of people with a phone call and a little bit of bass in your voice.
So tell me how to trigger the trapdoor.
It's behind your pinky. This could be our last chance to chat, you and I. For years, I ruled Hyperion from this room. And now you're here, where it all started. How's it feel, kiddo?
Uncomfortable.
There's something to be said for a cushy chair with a bunch of big important buttons that can raise hellfire on people.
Feels like I'm sitting in the chair of a supervillain.
But you could succeed where I failed.
Use our power to make things right, Reese.
But say, we shared the power I had when I sat in this room. What would you do with it?
Find out next time on Dragon Ball Z, I guess.
What the hell is taking him so long? Reese, the machine is off. Did you get the beacon? We're ready for you.
All good. Just getting into position.
Oh! Someone is here!
Hey!
Oh,
Gordas, yeah. Gordas. Gordas, come back here. Gordas.
Gordas, come back over here.
Dumb little robot. Let go, okay. Pick up broom.
I'm not supposed to tell you that. We're kind of in the middle. I'm sure she'd like to see you
too. Is it a vet?
Oh, hey, here she is.
Oh, Gordas, your naivety is both adorable and infinitely frustrating. Yeah, it's her. It's the bitch with the orange jumpsuit. No, that's bad.
So, if we could wield Hyperion's might together, how would you rule? Hypothetical, of course, but still, you gotta know what you want if you're gonna make it, kid. Like I told you after we escaped Old Haven, remember?
I'd fix Pandora. There's some good people down there, and they deserve better than a world full of psychos.
Yeah, that's what I wanted, but hell, maybe you'll pull it off. Who knows? You've done well so far, kid.
But imagine, Reese, if it wasn't hypothetical. You ever wonder why Nakayama created me? This whole AI thing? I was supposed to find a worthy successor to the Hyperion throne. And that successor, Reese, is you. If you join me, we can rule together. What do you say, kid?
This is the only room with the override port, so if you don't jack in now, you'll never get another shot.
Once again, I know how this game ends, so I'm really curious what happens if I push B.
Tick, 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 Greasy.
Hell no. You're a psychopath. Why would I trust you?
Okay, maybe do it with a little less vigor in your voice, Reese.
All the times I tried to help you after all we've been through.
You refuse everything you've ever wanted.
What I don't want is to jack you in.
The moment you plug me into your empty little head.
Kiss my ass. You died alone. No friends, no family. I am not gonna be you.
You don't deserve to be me, you piece of shit.
I'm done talking. I'm using the trapdoor.
Ah, right.
No, you really don't.
Doesn't matter what you say, he'll take control of you anyway. Oh, that's not good. Ow.
Reese, the machine is off. Did you get the beacon? We're ready for you.
Oh, that poor sweet Fiona. She never even caught on that I was in your head this whole time.
And this I love. I love the UI glitching out as you're losing control. This the corners of the screen's fading out.
I don't know why.
All good. Just getting into position.
What are you doing?
That shit's done. I'm everywhere in the system now. Not to mention my sweet new body.
You're a maniac.
No, I am handsome goddamn Jack!
Jack! Jack! Jack!
Oh, they don't even give you a next time? Oh, you want a little bit. They don't even give you a next time on... Oh, okay. Yikes. I mean, it makes sense. Gearing up for the grand finale, there's not much they could show without going into some spoiler territory, so I get it, but... Man, they... Yeah, so I remember how I felt when I had that cliffhanger for the first time. But also, as you can probably tell, that happens no matter what you do. Whether you reject Hyperion or accept it, Jack takes control and jacks into the system regardless. But putting aside the choice elements, story-wise, things are at their highest stakes ever, because now the plan has gone horribly wrong. Yvette's caught on to us. Jack's in the systems of Hyperion. And even if we somehow manage to escape this situation in peace, we still gotta deal with Valerie and all her goons after we escape this, so doesn't seem like there's any way for our characters to really get out of this in one piece. But we always find a way. And I guess, like, so that episode as a whole, definitely not as good as episode 3, because episode 3 took the time to flesh out the characters a little bit more. This one was less focused on character, more focused on just go, 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 get the plan done, do this, do that, and it was all about the infiltration of the facility, which is fun, as you can tell, the hijinks of how they solve problems, how they get from here to here. It's all really cool. The dynamics of bouncing off of a vet, discovering she betrayed you as Vasquez, not being able to, having to not tip her off that things have gone horribly wrong, and that you actually are Reese in disguise. That's cool. So that stuff is always, and of course the finger gun fight is hilarious. But as for the character stuff, you have Scooter's big send-off. That's the big scene. That's I imagine that the finger gun scene and the final moment where Jack takes control are probably going to be the big moments that stick in people's memories. But other than that, it doesn't really have the same level of character interaction between the cast that episode 3 had. Though there were also some more, I feel like there were more things this episode that annoyed me in terms of consistency and choices characters made and things that happened, like the elastic band snap, where it's like, did that really happen? Do we really buy that? I don't know that we buy that happened the way that you tell me it happened. So there were more things like that this time, but overall, still solid. If I had to rank the episode so far, it would probably be 3-1-4-2, I think? Maybe? 1 and 4 might trade places with each other, but I think 3 is definitely in the first position, and episode 2 is definitely in the last position. But it's always hard to rank these things, just because whatever you put in last, it always sounds like you just hate that one because it gets last place, but oftentimes it just means it's the least good one, not that it's the worst one, which technically means the same thing but with different connotations. In the same way that I would say the first Toy Story movie is the least good of the trilogy, but it's not the worst, because worst carries a different tone and connotation than if you say it's the least good thing. So I'd say episode 2 is the least good Tales of the Borderlands episode so far, but not the worst one, if you get what I mean. And yeah, that's Escape Plan Bravo. All we have left is episode 5, The Vault of the Traveler, which, as I mentioned at the end of Catch a Ride, is the episode that I have the most vivid memories of, because I loved it so much. And I think I mentioned this before as well. I'm pretty sure I replayed just specifically either the last episode or the end of the last episode because of how much I absolutely loved the way this game ended. So it could be the case that we started the next episode and I'm really disappointed by the finale and it doesn't live up to what I remember it being like when I played it as a kid. Or I'll be just as happy with it as I was back then and we'll end things off on a high note. The only thing I'm not super looking forward to is the actual ending, like the final 60 seconds of the game. But that's a whole other can of worms to open. We'll talk about that when we get to it. For now, we'll focus on, there's a lot left, and honestly, the other thing I'm excited to figure out is, because I know what happens in the final episode, I know the outline of the story, and all the major scenes, but there's a lot that we have left to wrap up. We still have to tie up the things with Valerie's goons and August. We have to get out of this place in one piece. We have to deal with Handsome Jack, but I know how that turns out. We have to get to the vault. There's a lot of characters left over that we haven't been able to fully follow up on. And I think that's going to tie into a wider discussion regarding the design of the game's narrative structure once we finish off. Uh-oh. What did I do? Oh, no, I didn't want to skip the credits. I didn't want to do that. I accidentally... The controller slid off the side of my armrest and hit the chair on one of the buttons. I don't know what button I pressed. I mean, probably A. Or maybe a start button or something. I did not want to skip the credits, but Apologies, that was not. I usually let the credits roll, but unfortunately this time that didn't work out too well. But anyway, yeah, there's something about sort of a wider point of conversation for how this game's story is told. Maybe not that, but maybe just how it's. I don't know. You'll see what I mean. I'll point it out when we get there. You might, if you know the big thing that makes episode 5 so dependent on your choices throughout the entire game, you probably know what I'm talking about. If not, then we'll get to it when we get there. Yeah, one more episode left. I think it's gonna end up being my favorite based on what I remember of it, but we won't know for sure until we actually play it. And that will be starting up tomorrow, and then we'll wrap everything up by Friday and end the year off on a high note, hopefully. So that'll be it for now. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for next time. And I hope to catch you all tomorrow for the start of the end of Tales from the Borderlands. Goodbye.
Take me someplace.